Hajimemashite. How is the jisaboke? How is the jet lag?
Enjoying it.
Enjoying the jet lag.
Enjoying it, yeah.
Are you a walking zombie?
Yeah. I just moved to LA, so I just flew from LA to London a couple of days ago. So, you know, my tour will start soon. So I'm just so excited.
Your visit obviously coincided with Fashion Week. You planned that very well, didn't you? You're a big fan of fashion.
I love it. I just, you know, went to Versus in Versace.
Yeah.
Show a couple of days ago. That was great. Intense collection. Yeah, Donatello was there. Yeah, so many people there. I really love fashion.
It's kind of really hard to kind of walk into the studios here at Absolute Radio without feeling a little underdressed because everyone's so beautiful outside. It's terrible. Goodness me. And you brought your good lady wife as well for a little while? Has the whole family come? Have you got the kids?
No. The kids have school.
Oh, yeah. Forgot about that.
They're going to the school in LA. So, yeah, my wife had to go back.
Okay, right.
Now I'm, you know...
Alone. Unbelievable. your guitar style, Omoshiroides, it's very interesting.
Thank you. I wanted to find kind of distinct the style because, you know, I'm a Japanese, Asian, and then I'm doing a Western culture.
Yeah.
Rock, funk, dance, blues. And I got inspired and influenced by many great, talented players.
Mm.
But at the same time, I felt responsibility to make something a little different, you know. So that's why I started slapping the strings.
Mm. Your whole style is really hitting that guitar. I mean, do your hands hurt after that? I mean, I've never seen anyone play the guitar quite like you, if you don't mind me saying.
It hurts.
Constantly.
In the show, I'm so excited and into it, so I don't feel anything. But sometimes, you know, the strings are all covered with my blood.
Good, classy.
But it's all about kind of passion, you know, emotion. That's all about it.
Mm.
So, yeah.
You're kind of stripping it back a little bit, and you've started using a Telecaster and kind of slowing it down a little bit.
Yeah.
Why did you go for that style for this album?
I mean, you know, still experimenting, you know, still challenging, you know. It takes time to invent something, you know, and then it's also risky.
Mm.
You know, I have my fans who have been supporting me for a long, long time. Of course, I don't want to disappoint them, but at the same time, I feel responsible to make something new, you know, so that, you know, we can share the excitement.
Yeah.
Excitement brings hope, you know. So, yeah, you know, as a guitarist, yeah, this time I started playing a Tele. It's huge, you know. People use Tele, you know, when it comes down to, you know, playing the rock track, but for me, actually, I was not, how does this, I was trying to avoid kind of that kind of instrument.
It's right, okay.
Typical rock, you know, Telecaster, Stratocaster, Gibson, Les Paul. But these days, I started feeling that as long as you have your core, you know, thought or style or message or yourself, it doesn't matter what it is, you know, what you play or what kind of style you do.
Yeah.
So, and then especially in Nashville, I actually, you know, how do you say, I had jam session with Robert Randles.
Mm.
That's still guitar.
Yeah.
He's amazing. And then, you know, we had jam session. He came down to the studio and hooked up with a kind of random amp. But the sound he created, the studio is intense.
Mm.
And then, you know, over the years, I started playing with a drummer, DJ, you know, many kind of, you know, instruments.
Mm.
I just, you know, wanted to have more bite and an edge on the sound. So I just, you know, picked the Telecaster.
Because historically, it's usually just been you and a drummer.
Yeah.
Which is, it's not uncommon, but it's certainly an interesting combination.
Yeah.
You've got to fill that sound.
I mean, you know, more freedom and a low budget.
Mm.
You know, and then you can do whatever. I hook up with the bass amp, the guitar amp, and at the same time, and yeah, you know, it's normal for me.
Mm.
And the drummer, the Bobo, you know, he's great.
Yeah, he's pretty good, isn't he?
It's you know, something new.
Mm.
You know, people haven't experienced before is really important to me as a creator, as a musician, as an artist. So, yeah.
How are you finding Los Angeles? Is it quite freeing to be able to just walk down the street and not necessarily create such a riot as you might do in your home country?
I mean, nice weather, actually.
Yeah, and the weather will always be nice.
Yeah, the kids love it. I mean, the good school, neighbors. Yeah. And there are two reasons why we moved to LA. The first is education. Because I was struggling to study English. I mean, still studying English. So I didn't want my kids to go through the same path.
Right, okay, yeah.
And then the second one is the opportunities, to be able to work with the producers or musicians, especially who made the history, you know, rock, funk, jazz, you know, the kind of music or culture history.
Mm.
So this time I just did the rearrangement for Mission Impossible.
Yes.
Yeah. And then, you know, I just met the Paramount Pictures people in LA and then I got an offer. But the time I got an offer, the idea of mixing that such an iconic theme of Mission Impossible and modern beat came up. And I just, you know, made the beat from 5/8 to 6/8.
You're right, okay.
So then I can put the downbeat. So, you know, that was my first time to put the orchestration too.
Mm.
So with Mike Einziger, the guitarist from Incubus, he's a good friend of mine, and his fiance Anne-Marie put the kind of orchestration.
Mm.
Yeah, I programmed everything for 4 or 5 days in a row. It took time, but I was so excited. And then also we recorded at Hans Zimmer's studio.
Right, wow, that's pretty good.
Yeah,
that's pretty filmic.
You know, on the hallway, many posters of
the things he's worked on.
Yeah, you know, The Lion King, even Mission Impossible 2.
Yes.
So Tom, you know, when I first met him in Tokyo at the premiere for Mission Impossible.
Because you played the theme at the premiere,
yes,
didn't you?
Yeah. Yes, you know, he was sitting there and he was at the studio for a month or 2 months for when he worked with Hans Zimmer for Mission Impossible 2. But anyway, so that kind of opportunity is really special than I had never had in Japan.
Yeah. Actually.
So that's, you know, that's one of the reasons why I moved to LA. And it's pretty exciting.
Mm. You went from being a massive rock star to acting without skipping a beat, really. I mean, you took a fairly hefty central role. Were you ever scared or worried or...?
Actually, at the last scene, I was scared.
Yeah, okay.
Until that moment, I didn't realize.
I imagine Watanabe was scared as well.
yeah, of course. But, you know, but to me, that was really important mission because that's meaningful.
Mm.
You know, when I first heard that project, I was also hesitant to do that because, you know, as a Japanese, it's really risky.
Mm.
It might, you know, collapse or ruin your career.
Yeah.
But when I first met Angie in Tokyo, she said that, you know, it's not about the war or, you know, the conflict between America and Japan. It's all about the human being and the strength, how strong a human being can be. And then through the life of Luis Zamperini, you know, we got the message and the attitude, you know, of peace, something that we need to pass to the next generation. And then I saw the footage that Luis Zamperini was running with local children in Nagano Olympics. And then everyone was smiling.
Hmm.
I thought that was everything.
Yeah. So
that's why I was able to tackle the role. And on set, I had to keep the distance from other actors. It's pretty intense. And then, but it's totally worth it.
Hmm.
You know, it's so that's why I did it.
So,
it's so much responsibility.
Are there any other roles coming up? Are you kind of working
with people? I'm just meeting up, you know, many directors or casting directors, but, you know, I'm not just professional actor.
Mm.
So it depends on the role and then, you know, the story and the meaning, everything. So, but I would love to do more, actually, yeah.
Yeah. Well, you're doing a very good impression of a professional actor, if you don't mind saying, goodness me. How many times since you arrived in Britain, as someone mentioned, the rugby, the Japanese beat the South Africans?
In the
last minute.
Yeah.
How many times has someone asked you about the Rugby World Cup since you've been here?
No.
Am I the first?
Yeah.
Oh, my word. So please. But you're more of a soccer guy, aren't you? Because you originally, tried out for a couple of teams, you played for a couple of teams in Osaka, and then you got an injury. Is that right? And then which forced you into playing music?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, how kind of... Would you have wanted to be a soccer player?
I mean, if I wouldn't have been kind of that trouble, I don't know. I'm enjoying being a rock star.
Rock star and film star.
Yeah,
it's
yeah,
a
yeah.
good second choice, isn't it, really?
It's a good
second choice. Check out Miavi at the Shepherd's Bush Empire on the 27th of September. It's been a pleasure, sir. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
Cheers.